two food trucks, only one Golden Spork.
Which dish will take top prize in our American Classic Challenge? This is Food Truck Rumble Char-Lit. Hillbilly Philly owner Rocco Wilcox started his food truck adventure at the young age of 23. He's only 25 now. He started working at a mobile concession stand for a local baseball team, and being the creative-minded guy he is, approached the owner with a plan to operate the stand as a food truck in the off-season. Well, sales skyrocketed that season, and Rocco acquired the beat-up food trailer. His plan? Serve cheesesteaks. Being from West Virginia, he decided to go with the name Hillbilly Philly and incorporate the bangs and bruises of the food cart into the brand. The secret to his killer cheesesteaks? Hillbilly Sauce. Derek and Sonia Worthy started Worthy Dogs Food Truck in 2012 after retiring. Derek had been working in the restaurant industry, and Sonia proudly served 24 years as a Marine. When Sonia's friend put her hot dog cart up for sale, the Worthies decided to buy it. At first, they had no intention of turning the hot dog cart into a full-time gig, but business kept growing, pushing them to go bigger. Their favorite thing about being in the food truck industry? Being able to hit the streets and feed those who may be struggling during the trying times. And it's a bonus to be able to spend time together as a couple. So what sets their dogs apart? Their condiments. From fresh pineapple salsa to handmade guac, their signature dogs serve up unparalleled flavor. Now, let's meet our judges. Winnie Bermudez at Winnie's World. Food and travel, combine the two and you've entered Winnie's World. Winnie Bermudez is a food and travel blogger based out of Char-Lit. She takes us from Tokyo, Japan to Park City, Utah through her writing on winniesworld.com. Dion Barry, Inside 485. Need to know where to grab grub around the Queen City? Writer and food blogger Dion Barry has you covered. He spotlights the area's must-try restaurants at inside485.com, as well as on Instagram and Twitter. Chris Rodarte, at Rodarte's Corner. Chris Rodarte is a Charlotte-based lifestyle content creator, and he loves to grub. Photographer and videographer by trade, his popular Instagram feed, filled with eye-catching snaps of the best bites around town and from his travels. He works with a variety of restaurants, brands, and businesses to amp up their content and style. All right, food trucks, you have 15 minutes to fix the ultimate American classic dish. Fire up those trucks. On your mark. Get set. Rumble!
All right, give me two steak, two beef fillies.
All right, so both of our food trucks today are going to take American classics and they're going to try to elevate them to the next level.
What we're gonna do today is a Sonoran dog. Originated out of Arizona. It'll consist of refried beans, guacamole, pico de gallo, shredded cheese, bacon. It's a dog that we like to introduce to Char-Lit. We wanted to do something no other hot dog vendor was doing.
Right now I'm grilling the onions and the meat, and then I take the meat and I put it on top of the onions, kind of steam it up, get that good juices flowing back down into the onions and the peppers, cook down.
All right, food trucks, 5 minutes down, 10 to go. 10 minutes.
Oh my God, no. Wow, that's a rookie maneuver. I need more rolls.
You burn?
Well, usually I forgot how hot this side of the grill is.
All right, Mrs. Worthy, I'm coming at you with five of them. Five Sonorans.
All right, I need mac and cheese bites. Y'all already got that stuff going. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, and you're good. I hit it with that au jus right here. It sets it off.
One thing we do is spiral our hot dogs, put grooves in them, extends them a little bit, and also allow you to put the toppings down in the middle of them.
Yeah, that's the million-dollar question. Do we go with provolone or white American right here for the competition? I know, right? The Hillbilly Philly style, though, is white American, so I guess that's what I gotta roll with.
I think white American.
Put a little press on it.
Oh, yeah. Extra cheese today.
All right, food trucks, 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Time to start finishing up.
5 minutes. Let's go, designers.
Make sure you go all the way down to the end, Mrs. Worthy. You want to be able to taste it with every bite.
That's the money shot right here. This is what you want to see. Look at that.
Man, I'm feeling pretty strong. Hopefully we can take this Golden Spork home.
Hey man, what is the Hillbilly Philly if not a show?
Come on, baby, we got 3 minutes. Pick it up. 3 minutes.
God, I am so freaking jittery right now.
Be careful, don't bust the bun over.
All right, you ready?
You can go ahead and start lining them up.
A separate box?
No, we're gonna make them look good, so I'm gonna put them in. Don't worry. It's that Hillbilly Philly sauce.
I want to be able to fold a little bit.
All right, give me some regular fries.
Yeah, like that one. Good move.
We're done.
All right, food trucks, 1 minute left. 1 minute, and Rocco's done. Rocco's outside eating. All right, Derek, you got a little less than a minute here.
Thank you, my brother. I'm moving it.
He's moving those dogs. 10.
Oh, we got it. Okay, that's the fourth. All right.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That is time. This rumble is over. First up, we have Hillbilly Philly. Rocco, tell us about the dish.
It's basically your regular Philly cheesesteak with white American cheese. We have our special Hillbilly sauce. The technical term for it would be a Cajun garlic remoulade, I believe, but we call it Hillbilly sauce. And then it's on an Amoroso roll. That's basically right out of Philadelphia. Cajun fries and mac and cheese bites.
Up next in our rumble, we have a worthy dog. Derek, tell us about the dish.
Well, here we have the Sonoran Dog. It consists of refried beans, guacamole, salsa, pico de gallo, and cilantro with a cilantro lime sauce.
I would say first impressions, I would go to the hot dog. I mean, opening that up, you don't see that here in this area. All the ingredients and just, it just looks amazing.
For overall taste, I think that the Philly just, it was very homey. It's a very homey taste. It's very familiar, but it's like an elevated familiar. It's everything packs a punch and it just goes so well together.
Yeah, I think for wow factor, I've also got to go with my friends at Hillbilly. For sure, from the smell to the sights, the sauces, the cheeses, the mac bites, you're overwhelmed by it almost.
So, do we think we have our winner?
I think so.
Yeah.
For sure. It's tough, I think one edged it out.
Yeah.
So, judges, decision made?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, we definitely have. Worthy Dog, we love that you introduced a Sonoran Dog to this area. It's definitely a different take on a hot dog, and all the elements worked, and it's definitely Instagrammable. Like, the presentation looked amazing.
Hillbilly Philly, we really appreciated how everything came together in your dish. The sauce, the cheese, the buns, even the mac and cheese bites. It was really down to earth and really effective.
So, the winner of the Golden Spork is...
Hillbilly Philly.
Oh, it feels amazing. I'm super excited to have won it, and I'm excited to come back for the next competition.
Well, the experience, man, I love it. It wasn't a competition to me. We're from the same food truck community. Just come out to have fun, show our dishes off. We enjoyed ourselves.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks for joining us for Food Truck Rumble Char-Lit. Good bite and good night.